My name is Tom from Boca Virtual Golf, and I'm going to give you a quick tutorial on how our system works. So, our hitting area is all located right here, all three hitting areas. You have fairway and putting from right here on the left side of the tee, and then you've got your tee area, and then you have sand and rough on the other side here. Now, the tee area, you can screw with the tees in and out. We have different height tees that you can pop in and out if you'd like a different size. Now, the hitting area is basically this circle right here. If the ball comes outside of the hitting area, the green light that you see on the top of the screen is going to turn yellow or red, meaning the simulator is not picking up the ball the way it should. Now, I have a green light right now, but if there's a second ball in the area, I still have a green light. But that's not good, because the simulator will be confused, and as you'll see right here, it does not pick up my shot. So what I need to do is move this second ball out of the area, make sure I've got a green light, and then swing away. Once you get to the first tee, you're going to see the player that's up, their name, the distance to the hole, and the elevation from the ball to the hole. Okay? You're going to be aimed directly straight out. You can come over to the touch screen and you can tap to see a better idea of where you're aiming. You can also adjust your aim by tapping the aim button and moving your aim back and forth. Okay? Under options and scoring is where you're going to find things like mulligan and drop ball. Now I'm going to go ahead and hit my tee shot so you can see how this progresses. So now after the first person hits their tee shot, the system will automatically bring up the next person in line to hit their shot. It's also going to tell you who's up next in the upper right-hand corner. Okay, so my approach shot here is sitting right on the fringe. The reason I know that is because shot type full in the corner is glowing red, letting me know that it's not looking for a putt, it's actually looking for a chip. I can also see that the distance is 11 yards, it's not showing feet, and my lie is approach. So I do want to putt this though, so I'm going to come over to the screen and I'm going to tap the red area that says shot type full, and it'll switch to putt, give me a different view, tell me that I now have 33 feet, and I'm doing a medium putt. So most people do prefer to putt from off the edge of the green, but you can also chip it if you want. This is only showing if you want to switch to a putt. All right, so I've made it to the green. Now let's talk about putting. I've got a putt here. I've got 9 feet. And the elevation is only down about a quarter inch. So I can see the break on the green here, illustrated by these beads. So I know that this putt is going to go from right to left a little bit. Now the tee area to the screen is 13 feet. So a 9-foot putt that's a little bit downhill, I'm not going to want to get it all the way to the screen unless I can nail the hole. So I'm going to give this a shot and show you how accurate our simulators are. There we go. Okay, now we went over a putt that's under 13 feet. Now if you have a putt that's over 13 feet, the distance from the tee to the screen, what you're going to want to do is hit it as if it would go that distance going through the screen. So here I've got a 27-foot putt that's downhill 4 inches. Now, each inch of elevation equates to about a foot of rollout. So I'm gonna hit this as if it's gonna go about 23 feet or 10 feet through the screen. And I'm gonna play this double break here a little bit, try to basically get this to nuzzle up there pretty close to the hole. Okay, so the final thing I'd like to show you here is our tour balls that we sell behind our bar. We sell them for $5. You keep it, you bring it home, you play with it every time you come in here. It's got a urethane cover on it to get the better feel and extra spin, because the simulator actually picks up the spin of the ball. So if you've got a urethane cover and it's spinning more, you're going to get more spin, more check around the greens, more control on your trajectory. So I'm going to hit a standard ball that we have in here with the black lines, and this is from 51 yards. I'm going to try to do the same exact shot with my wedge here and see the difference in the spin. I'm going to do a mulligan now. That was 3,598 RPMs of backspin. And now with the tour ball. You can see how that checked a little more. 7,397 RPMs of backspin. So, $5 if you want to try it. If you play a Pro V1 or a Chrome Soft or something like that outside, you might want to try our tour balls to make your experience here even better.